Hi, I'm Franco Rotoli from the Solidworks training team. This is the fourth video in the Beginner's Guide to xDesign series where I'm modeling a phone holder. Today, I'll be using all the components I modeled in the previous videos to create an assembly of our phone holder. I'll also add in a couple of other components to complete the assembly. Let's jump into xDesign and start assembling. Just like all the other components, we start from the xDesign main screen. I'll select New Component and name it Phone Holder. Note the collaborative space I'm using and click OK. On the action bar, there's an assembly tab. This has a unique set of tools that help us create, manipulate, and work with our assemblies. If I want to start a new component from scratch, this is the Insert New Component command. I'll cover that in a future video. Right next to it is the Insert Component command. We use this if we already have existing components to add to the assembly, which I do. When I click it, a window comes up where I can see my recent files, or I can use the search functionality to search all the files I have access to. The first component I'll insert is the backplate, which we modeled in the last video, so it's in my recents list. Single-clicking it will insert it and align the planes and origins. In the Design Manager, we see the name of the component is here with an anchor next to it. This means the component is fixed and not movable. We can float it with a right click if needed. Also, if I click the triangle to expand it, we see that I have access to the entire Design Manager. This will come in handy later. I'll hide the planes for now to clean things up a little. I'll also pin my view bar and fit the model to the screen. Now, I'll insert my next component from the recents list. I'll pick the arm. xDesign also drops this on the origin, but it's not fixed. I can move it around by dragging it. Since this assembly needs two arms, I could use the Insert Component button again, or by right-clicking the arm in the Design Manager, I'll choose Duplicate. This makes a copy of the arm in this assembly. Both of these are the same component, so changes to one will show in both. We'll see that in a minute. Now I'll start putting these parts together. On the assembly toolbar, the icon that looks like a paperclip is the Mate tool. This is how we assemble components and position them relative to one another. The dialog is very simple. It just asks me to select geometry. I can select faces, edges, points, planes, and more. And depending on what I choose, it'll give me different options. I'll choose this face on the arm and this one on the backplate. Now I have several options for which mate to add. The first one is coincident, which will essentially make the faces coplanar. Clicking it will move the arm to satisfy the mate. In this case, it's not the way I'd like it. I need to flip the arm over. Before clicking the Apply and Continue button, I'll choose the Flip Orientation button. This gives me the other solution for the mate. Clicking the Apply and Continue button adds the mate in the Design Manager and clears the Mate dialog for more selections. I'll make these two faces coincident as well and flip the alignment. We can now see this arm can only move in this direction because it has to respect the two mates I added. Also note that the components are free to move through one another in this mode. That's helpful during this phase so we don't get bogged down with interferences. xDesign does have modes where we check for interferences, but we'll save that for another video. Next, I'll bring this arm closer to its position. There's a faster way to add mates in xDesign. If I select two faces using the Control key on my keyboard, a pop-up window comes up with the same mate icons as before. I'll choose Coincident from here, and the arm snaps into place. If the alignment is off, I can easily click the Flip Alignment button from this pop-up. I'll finish positioning this arm by adding one more coincident mate and flipping the alignment. Next, I'll add two more components, a round disc named Cog to connect the arms, and a pin to hold it all together. Again, using Control and selecting two faces, I'll add a coincident mate between the round cog part and the back plate here. Control selecting the two cylindrical faces brings up some different mate types. I'll make these two faces concentric. As I mentioned before, when I add mates, xDesign categorizes them at the bottom of the Design Manager here. Next, let's position this pin. I'll add a concentric mate between the cylindrical faces and a coincident mate between the cog face and the bottom of the head. By dragging the components around, we start to see how this assembly is going to work. As I said earlier, mates don't always have to be between faces. I'll expand the Design Manager of the cog component and show a sketch that was created at the center of the slots. I want to mate the center point of the arm standoffs to these sketch lines. An easy way to modify components in an xDesign assembly is to simply double-click the component. This puts you into edit mode for that component, and you can see that the rest of the assembly has turned transparent. I'll start a sketch on this face and add a sketch point, minding my cursor feedback and automatic sketch relations. To exit the sketch, I'll click this icon with the green check. And to go back to editing the assembly, I'll click the Return to Root Product icon. Root product is xDesign's term for the base part or assembly. The sketch I just created is under the arm component. If it wasn't shown, I could show it now. And since both arms in this assembly are copies of the same part, the sketch shows up in both. I'll now add a coincident mate between the arc sketch in the cog and the point sketch in the arm, and repeat it for the other arm. I'll use my view flyout to change to an isometric view and hide the sketches for both components from the Design Manager. We can now see what the assembly motion looks like. Moving one arm will turn the cog and symmetrically move the other arm. To complete the assembly, I'll bring in the phone component we modeled in the first video and mate it into place with coincident mates on the back and bottom. I'll show the planes and add a coincident mate between the center planes to center the phone. Saving the assembly completes this beginner's guide to xDesign. Thanks for watching. For even more great content, click on the link in the description below to access additional tips, tricks, and training courses. And as always, happy modeling.